Namaste students, I am your biology teacher from Dalmia Vidya Madhya School, Dalmiapuram. Children, in the previous class I taught about useful microorganisms. Now I am going to teach the next part of the same lesson, microorganisms. Some of the microorganisms cause disease to human beings and also plants and animals. How do the microorganisms enter inside the human body? How can we prevent the disease? Children, the microorganism enter inside the human body through the air, food, water and also insect bite. Now the person is infected by disease. The infected person cough or sneeze. So at that time the droplets come out of the mouth or from the nose. The droplets contain large amount of germs. So the disease causing germs are known as pathogens. Now the germs are present in the air. When a healthy person inhale the air from the infected person, the germs are enter inside the healthy person. So how can we prevent such a kind of airborne diseases? When we cough or sneeze, we have to use the handkerchief. Children, nowadays, some persons are not using the restroom. They are using the open place for defecation. Urine as well as the fecal matter contain large amount of germs. The houseflies sit on the fecal matter or urine. They carry the germs. Here we are able to see the food items in the open condition. The houseflies sit on the food item. Already they carry the germs. Now the germs are enter inside the food item. The food item which contain the germ is known as contaminated food item. When we eat the contaminated food item, through the food item the germs also enter inside the body and cause the disease. So we have to maintain the hygienic condition. We have to keep our surroundings in a clean way. So at that time we can prevent the entry of the flies. And also the food items should be covered. After using the toilet, we have to wash our hands thoroughly. And also before eating, we have to wash the hands thoroughly. The hands also carry lot of germs. Nowadays, many persons are affected by COVID-19 virus infection. Government also announced to wash the hands regularly. So hand washing is a good practice to prevent the disease. Sometimes the disease transmitted through the insects also. Now the person is affected by disease, maybe a malarial disease. Now the insect bite the infected person and also suck the blood from the infected person. When the mosquito suck the blood from the infected person, along with the blood, some germs also enter inside the mosquito. Now the mosquito carry the germ. Again the same mosquito bite a healthy person and suck the blood from the healthy person. When it suck the blood from the healthy person, it inject the germ inside the healthy person. In such a kind of way, the germs are transferred from infected person to healthy person. So here the insects only carry the germs from one person to another person. That's why insects are known as carriers. And then we have to maintain the personal hygiene. We have to wash our hands. We have to keep our surroundings in a clean way. Then only we are able to protect ourselves from the disease. Maintain the personal hygiene. Drink boiled water. We have to maintain the social distance. So follow all these things. Children, we will meet in the next class. Thank you, students.